not on une histoire de femme, aka Story of Women. A great film. It has one of the best actresses in the world. In fact, I keep saying this. In my book, she is probably the best in the first place, sharing it with Meryl Streep. Isabelle Huppert, phenomenal. She can do anything, and that's one reason why. She has been good decades ago, she's good now, and she takes such challenges. I'm thinking Elle, the film for which she was nominated for an Academy Award a few months ago. She won the Golden Globe, because there they have, of course, two categories, drama and comedy. Emma Stone won the Golden Globe and the Oscar, the Golden Globe for comedy, Isabelle Huppert for drama. And she is a woman who is not 20, 30, 40 anymore. She's 50, heading towards 60, or thereabouts, and she's involved into a very weird relationship. She's great, but she seems to like this. It's BDSM, bondage, sadomasochistic. It's complicated. And to compare, I think she's worthy of the highest honors. She's there at the top, as I said. And when comparing with Emma Stone, I don't see. And I'm probably mistaken. I don't see why Emma Stone should have an Academy Award. And Isabelle Huppert, no. It's besides, to mention an aside, this has an impact on the life expectancy of people. Psychology, positive psychology studies have determined that status can prolong life, or vice versa, cut it short, well, shorter. Academy Award winners have been proved to live longer than those who have been just nominated. And it's not just one study, which can be wrong, it can be coincidence, it can be other things, but they've studied also British civil servants, and status again accounted for differences in length of life. To try and return, Isabelle Huppert is Marie Latour, married to Paul, François Cluzet, another great French actor. She lives in poverty, and at one moment, on account of circumstances, she is performing an abortion, and then she finds that this can be something to do to lift herself a little from poverty, destitution. Abortions with water and soap. Clients, this is the German occupation, the Nazis took advantage of their position, some were collaborators. Anyway, many women wanted to get rid of unwanted babies. And at another stage, she becomes a sort of a madame. I don't know the term for the pimp, female pimp. If she's not really called a pimp as the man, la patronne, she's renting rooms for hookers. And with that, she becomes a complex character. Of course, there's a dark side. Not only she does abortions, which might be seen as a necessary evil because of the situation I just described to some extent, but to rent rooms, and her attitude is both evil, an unethical, morally vicious thing to do. And she's also a victim. Remember, she was left in destitution. Her husband is somewhat, or to a great extent, useless. And he comes back from the conflict with problems, PTSD, and so much more. And a victim because at one point she is taken into custody and she faces the death penalty, no less. And this is also a paradox, a huge controversy, to say the least. Because on the one hand we have the Vichy regime collaborating, sending multitudes Jewish people, in particular, and mostly Jewish, but some other categories as well, to death camps, and then pretending to be pure, so to say, and expose and sentence maybe this woman for abortions. I mean, what's at least we can say double standards.